right, guys, welcome to Love Lifts. We got a back workout today, back and biceps, actually, so a pull workout. We're going to work today mostly on back thickness, and so that's what I'm going to take you through. So enjoy the workout, and I'll see you in a little bit. All right, so we're going to start with rack cleans, or rack pulls, rack cleans. We're going to start with rack pulls, and so what I have set up here is the bar at just below. Hopefully you should be able to see that. The bar is going to be right at knee or just below the knee. It's okay to go a little bit lower, but you don't want to go too low. I like it right here. And basically you're doing a deadlift, but you're just working on the top range of the motion. So I like this because you can go a little bit heavier. You can really pull and work on just the top range of the motion, and it really engages the lats and really works on the back. So let's get after it.
How are you doing?
Alright, now we're going to go to the row machine. So anytime you're doing any kind of a row movement, you're going to be working more the thickness of your back than the width. So anytime you're out wide, obviously you're going to go width. Anytime you're in close and pulling, you're going to go more thickness. But one thing to keep in mind here that I want you to work on is really making sure that you're pulling with your back and not letting your biceps take over. And so you'll see in my motion when I'm pulling, I'm really pulling the back and getting a big contraction out of the back, trying not to let the biceps take over. So make sure you pay attention to that. I can tell you that it's still, this is day two back at the gym after the 2 week break, and I can definitely tell you that the weight just feels heavy. I feel a little bit lethargic. I definitely am getting good pumps and I'm feeling good at the same time, even with that weirdness. Probably from all those Christmas cookies, I got plenty of glycogen and fuel to use. Yeah, the weight definitely just feels heavy, but it definitely feels good just to get things moving, get the blood flowing, get the body working and all that, so it definitely does feel good. I'm glad I'm here, but the first week or week and a half or so back, as always, gives me reasons why not to skip days anymore. All right, so now we're gonna do another variation of a row. We're just gonna do a dumbbell row off the rack for the back, I guess you could say. So, join me there.
I'm gonna go to the other day, he's like, oh, I'm sorry.
Alright guys, I am going to do one lat pull down on the lat pull down machine, or the diverging lat pull down. Anyway, so I'm going to do at least one of these, or at least one of these workouts just to kind of round out the back day, and then we'll jump into some biceps. Alright, we're gonna jump into some biceps now. I'm gonna start with this, let's see what they want to call it. I guess they just call it a biceps curl machine. I really like it. I like it because it keeps constant tension, and I'll show you how I hold the grips on this, the handle, and I put the rope or the cable, whatever you want to call it, cord, whatever you want to call it. We'll say rope. On the outside in your hand, so when you grab it like this, so that when you curl, I like to grab more on the top, so that when you curl, what happens is there's a lot of tension on the supination portion of the motion, as well as obviously the curl part, and so it just really helps target kind of the full contraction of the bicep. You'll have to lower the weight a little bit to do that, because it does put that extra tension on, but I think you get a much better contraction, a better tension on the fullness of the contraction and the purpose of the bicep to curl and to supinate the forearm. So I'm going to start with this, and then we'll go hit two more exercises, and then I'll give you guys some tips. Alright, we're gonna go to our second arm workout. We're gonna do this arm curl machine. Now, I like this machine because you can normally overload it a little bit more with weight, because it does shorten the range of motion a little bit by getting your arms in front of your body. So if you're really on a good stretch and a full stretch and contraction on the bicep, it's best to get the arm behind your body, which is gonna be the last workout we do. So this one, with the arm being in front of the body, it does shorten it a little bit, but you get to overload the weight a little bit more than you would with your arm behind your body. So you just kind of hit it in a different way. But I like this machine, so let's get it. All right, we're gonna head over to the dumbbell area. We're gonna do incline dumbbell curls, so the arm gets behind us a little bit, get a full stretch. A little bit lighter weight here, but we're going for the full contraction. I'm gonna work on the curl and the supination of the forearm. So that's what this exercise is. Set this up. See if it'll work. Almost didn't step on the step. Set this up so I can give you guys my five top workout tips. So here's my top five workout tips. Number one is care about those cliche sayings, those quotes. Those quotes that everybody knows that people just kind of will typically dismiss and just say, no, I got that. Or, like, there's a quote over here on the wall that says, do today what others won't, so that you can do tomorrow what others can't. And I know it's cliche, I know it's cheesy. One of my favorite ones is, the only difference between those who do and those who don't is that those who do did and those who don't didn't. And I know that there's more to that. I know that many try to do, but failed and didn't. But at least they can say, hey, I gave it a shot. I think those quotes are cliche because they're overused. They're overused because they're true. And I think they're important when we understand that life is about more than luck or chance or things just happening to you. But I think it's more about you happening to life. Another cliche quote, don't let life happen to you, happen to life. But it's true. You have to take it and make it yours and own it and take that responsibility. Those quotes are important, and I think they're valuable for us to take a deeper look at them and how to apply them to our life. I'm out of breath. To our life, rather than just saying, oh no, oh whatever, oh it's cliche. Yeah, but the truth. Take the principles and figure out how to apply it to your life. That's tip number one. Number two, stop caring about the weight. Too many people are trying to get a number up. And I'm not saying don't have goals. I'm not, obviously have goals. I'm not saying don't not care about it at all. I'm just saying stop worrying about it, because the weight doesn't matter. Your muscle contraction matters. Contract your muscle. Don't worry about what the weight says, because maybe you come in, you put up a big weight, but you have bad form, you're gonna end up hurting yourself. Or you put up too small of a weight because you're just starting, you're trying to increase it, but you can't do it, and so you sacrifice quality. But quality is the only thing that's gonna keep you going. You can't survive off of getting after it and trying to put up a big weight. You need quality in your life. Quality beats quantity every time. And again, there's that cliche quote again, but at the same time, it's valuable and it's true and it's worth it. So stop worrying about the weight you're lifting and just worry about the contraction of your muscle and making sure that you're getting the most out of your workout. And number two kind of ties into number three, being that stop worrying about everybody else. A lot of people won't start because they feel like they're gonna look goofy in the gym, or they don't really know what to do. And it's okay to look goofy, it's okay to not know what to do, but learn and grow and do it. And again, the only difference between those who do and those who don't is those who do did and those who don't didn't. Stop worrying about everybody else. Worry about yourself, take care of yourself, and make sure that you give yourself some priority and do what's best for you. Put in the effort, put in the work. Number four is, I don't want to do cardio anymore. Number four is control the weight. Control what you're doing. Care about what you're doing. I guess I'll word it this way. I see a lot of people in the gym working hard. I'd say most people here are working hard. Every once in a while, we see the person that's here that's not working hard. But I'd say most people are here working hard. But I think that there's more to it than just working hard. And that's putting in the hard work. Another cliche quote. I will say that there's a big difference between working hard and putting in the hard work. Working hard, you can come in and you can bang weight around. You can get on the treadmill, the stair climber, sweat your butt off, and think, there, I did it. And certainly, maybe you're getting some done. But if you're here, you might as well do it right. If you're gonna show up, you might as well get everything you possibly can out of it and make it the best that you possibly can. And so put in the hard work. Take the time to research workouts. Take the time to write your exercises down and the weights that you're doing, so that every couple of weeks you can be adding some weight and having that progressive overload over the long haul, so that you're growing and you're getting everything that you possibly can out of the valuable time in your life you're spending here. You might as well get everything that you possibly can out of it by putting in the hard work and learning. And not letting this just be a thing that you go and do and you just happen to go to the gym every once in a while, or make it valuable, make it important, make it count. Number five would be, do it today. That's a quote that I have, and I'm sure I'm not the first person to say it, but do it today. Stop worrying about whether or not you did it yesterday. Stop worrying about what you did last month. Stop worrying about what you did last year. I know things have consequences and I know things have effects, but if you don't do it today, you'll never overcome it. You'll never look at those mistakes, challenges, or circumstances from your past. You'll never get over it. You'll never live free from what you did or didn't do in the past. If today you don't make the decision to do it, be it go to the gym, be it eat healthy, be it love your wife, love your husband, love your kids, be a valuable employee to wherever you work. You can apply this to any area in life. Do it today. Whatever you didn't do yesterday, don't worry about it. Do it today though. do the right thing today. And with that, you can't worry about tomorrow either. You don't have tomorrow. You can't do what you want to do tomorrow. You can only do it today. More cliche quotes, but there's so much value in putting the effort and saying, I'm going to worry about today. I'm going to take care of today. And tomorrow, if I'm blessed enough to have it, I'll do it tomorrow. But I have today. I have right now. I'll do it today. My top five tips for you are really things that you can apply to your work life, your family life, your friend life, your workout life, like I'm obviously doing here. There's a lot of different principles you can take out of all this, but just to list them off for you one more time. Number one is pay attention to those quotes. Take the principles from them and apply them to your life. Number two, stop worrying about the weight. Just worry about yourself. Number three, stop worrying about everybody else. Again, worry about yourself. Number four is control the weight. I guess a life application, and that could be take control of yourself. Be responsible for yourself. Know that you have value, you have purpose, and whether or not everybody else or anybody else thinks that, that's up to them. But you yourself have value. Take control of that. Number five is do it today. Do it today. That's all I have for you guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. Man, I am not a cardio fanatic. This is not my favorite thing to do in the world. In fact, I only do this when it's prep time because nobody likes this. I know a lot of people like, I like cardio. They're lying. No, they don't. Nobody likes cardio. Cardio is hardio. Ugh. Bonus tip. Wipe down your machines. It's gross if you don't. Also, put your weight away. Have a good one.